Hey, y'all. Hey, hey, y'all.
Shh. Oh. We're trying to blend in.
Oh, hey, you're going to enjoy today's episode.
We're looking for ducks.
And bear. I can't find bear.
Oh, he's always looking for bear. That's right. Oh, y'all don't know who I am.
This is Camo Kyle. That's right.
That's Bear Grylls. No, you're Cub Wylde.
Yeah, I'm Bear Grylls' cameraman. Yeah. Anyway, he's going to show me some new stuff.
I'm going to show him how to blend in.
Check it out.
He doesn't blend in very well.
That's
right. We're going to teach him today. But y'all ain't going to believe what happened. Y'all need to watch through because I fell in the water.
That's right. I witnessed it.
Yeah, it was not no bueno.
Check it out.
As they say.
That's right.
Check it out. Y'all ready for today's episode? It's going to be great.
Through you. is moving right now. You were still showing up, happy to my baby Lazarus. Your voice is calling me out, and right.
I'm Natalie, and today is a special Sunday. It's Agreement Sunday, one of my favorite. So we're talking about the prayer of agreement, and Jesus taught us about the prayer of agreement in Matthew chapter 18, verse 19. Read our memory verse with me. It says, "Again, I say to you that if two of you agree on earth concerning anything that they ask, it will be done for them by my Father in heaven." Matthew 18, 19. Kids, the prayer of agreement is like playing tug of war. If Brother Keon and Brother Justin play tug of war and pull against each other, let's see what happens. 3, 2, 1, pull! Oh, celebration, it looks like a stalemate. Why? Because they're pulling against one another. But let's see what happens if they pull together. 3, 2, 1, pull! Celebration, when you pray the prayer of agreement, we want to encourage you, you need to find a faith buddy, somebody that's going to believe God's word and pray with you. For instance, if you're praying and believing God for healing and your friend tells you, well, I just don't think God could heal you, that's not a faith buddy. But if you find a friend that'll pray with you and says, sure, Isaiah 53 says that by Jesus' stripes you were healed, that's a great faith buddy. Another faith buddy is your pastor. Your pastor would love to pray and believe God with you. Well, today's Bible story is about the woman with the issue of blood, found in Mark chapter 5. The Bible says that she had had a disease. She'd been bleeding for 12 years, but she heard about Jesus and she used her faith. She said to herself, if I would just touch the hem of his garment, touch his clothes, I'll be made well. And kids, she did just that. She pressed through a crowd of people that she wasn't supposed to be around. She touched Jesus and Jesus stopped, asked who touched him, and told that woman that her faith had made her well. So we encourage you to find a faith buddy to pray the prayer of agreement with. And don't forget to watch all the way to the end of today's episode for another secret code.
What up, YouTube? You already know I like my energy drink. Some Monster right here. This is Ultra Paradise. It's good. We're gonna drink it Kyle style. Woo!
Yeah, that's good. I love my energy drinks.
Woo! Oh wait, I probably shouldn't have thrown that on the ground. Hold on.
Woo, baby!
Guys, guess what? Trying something new today. 5-hour energy, 99 cent bottle. I don't know if I trust 99 cent energy drinks, but we about to try it. I can already feel my heart. It's like boom, 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 boom. Okay, you know, it feels like a gorilla. Oh, that smells bad. That's disgusting. You don't want 5-hour energy, kids. No bueno, as they say in Rome. Woo! How y'all doing? Can I pet your dog? Hey, buddy. Guys, I'm here with this dog. He's really sweet. Hey, buddy. Look at him. Beautiful boy. Woo! Woo! Okay. Hey, guys, what's up? It's me. Welcome to the vlog. It's Camo Kyle. How y'all doing? Woo! Woo! Oh, it didn't work, guy. Woo! Woo! Oh! Hey, Bo. Hey, Bo. I'm Camo Kyle. How y'all doing? Hey, Bo. It's Camo Kyle, y'all already know who it is. We out here in the woods, we might have some ducks out here, some deer. You already know the drill. Woo!
We on the way, we going?
We on the way, okay? We on the way. Woo! Is that Cub Wylde? Hey, it's Cub Wylde. Hey, you going to the river with me, Cub Kyle?
That's right, let's do it.
All right, let's go do it. It's Camo Kyle, vlog 222. You already know, it's gonna be lit. We're in the woods again. You already know the Kyle vibe. Can't beat Camo Kyle.
Cub Wild's gonna shave too.
Cub Wild, why are you shaving in the woods, brother?
I forgot to shave this morning, man.
Come on, Cub.
For the deer.
Hey, Cub, man. Look good for the deer.
Woo! Woo! That's how we call each other in the woods. He'll be at one deer stand, I'll be at the other, and we'll be like, okay. Woo! Woo!
Woo! Woo! I'm teaching you to blend in today, right?
Yep, that's Jesus. Right.
We're blending in. Woo! Right in the woods, me and Cub Wylde.
Let's go, Camo Kyle.
Woo!
Gotta find us a good hiding spot.
Yeah, we gotta go camouflage. Hey, you ready, Cub Wylde?
I'm ready.
Wait, don't you have a canoe?
I do. Woo! Woo! What's up, y'all?
What's up, y'all? I'm Camo Kyle.
Yo, we got some great footage. You know, see how wet he is?
Hey, look.
He
look,
fell in the
check
water.
It out, check it out, check it out. Okay, look. I'm soaking wet. I got the drip, okay? So look, what we got here, right? We were in that canoe.
Right there.
We were right there.
We were in paddling that, around out here.
In that canoe.
He's supposed to be showing me how to blend in.
That's right.
And he even blended into the water today.
I blended into the water today. It was pretty cool.
Anyway. I didn't want to do that today, though.
Well, you should have. Look, anyways, guys, we were over there, and all of a sudden, I tried to get out of the boat, tried to turn around, and all of a sudden, right. Boom!
Yep.
I fell in the water.
I witnessed it. I witnessed it.
We got a clip. Check it out.
There, we got some good stuff over here. Well, oh, hey there, kids. Man, it's good to see y'all. Man, I'm out here, Cub Wylde again. I'm out here with Bear, and you know what? The other day, we met a new guy named Camo Kyle. Camo Kyle, hey, what's up, man?
Hey, what up,
come over here. Now, Camo Kyle, you can see how camouflaged he is. He brought his boat today, and I'm helping you out. I'm helping you out, man. He's going to help me understand how to blend in better with Bear.
You ready
to go?
I'm Camo Kyle.
You ready to go, Camo?
Hey, man, I'm ready to go, bro.
I'm gonna call you CK, okay?
I don't like CK, bro.
CK. All right, CK.
No, I don't like CK. Man, you're going to get this boat off balance, bro.
All right, hold on. We got to get off here, buddy.
Where are we going?
All right.
Come on, Camo Kyle, we go. Wait.
This way.
Kyle, why
man, you never done a canoe before?
No, man.
Hey, you got to paddle this way, bro. Wait, I'm backwards.
No, you're not.
Why didn't you tell me I'm backwards?
Yeah, no. You're gonna have to turn around and then let me out. But I was trying to put you up there so that you could easily turn around without flipping.
No, you're not understanding. The whole boat needs to be flipped.
That's what I tried to tell you, buddy.
Hey, Bo, y'all ain't gonna believe what just happened now.
Ah, I told you, Camo Kyle.
So,
I told you.
Look, we were in this here canoe right here. Right here, you see it, kids? Right there, that canoe right there. You see how it's all dirty right there? Well, we were just in that canoe, and as you can see, I'm dripping
he
wet.
He fell out.
I fell out. I didn't listen. We weren't in agreement.
That's right. That's right, Camo Kyle. CK, so, I told you.
I should have just listened I gotta have a nickname for you. Cubby. Cubby is his name.
No, I don't know.
Anyway. Cubby.
But look. We prayed the prayer of agreement.
That's right. What scripture do we use?
Matthew 18:19.
That's right. We're only two of you. We're in agreement. Listen.
He lost his phone, and guess what?
I lost my earphone. Look, kids, right here. I got it right here. This phone, as you can see, it's soaking wet. It's covered in slime and everything else. Look, but we prayed. I was sitting right here in the pond right there, and he was over there digging with his canoe. And
my paddle.
Yeah, and we just started praying, and that's how it went. And that's all right. Of a sudden, you know, it just happened.
That's right.
And he felt it vibrating under his foot, and we got it. Amen.
Right out of the water.
That's right.
Right out of the water.
Well, this has been CK and Cubby. We'll see y'all later.
Today's Bible story is found in Mark chapter 5, verses 21 through 34.
Jesus stood on the shore of the Sea of Galilee, and a large crowd gathered around him. Jairus, one of the leaders in the synagogue, fell at Jesus' feet and begged for his help. "My daughter is about to die. Please come touch her so she will be healed and live," he said. Jesus went with Jairus, and many people followed, crowding around him. In the crowd was a woman who had been bleeding for 12 years. She had seen many doctors and had spent all her money trying to get better, but no one could help her. She was getting worse. The woman said to herself, "If I touch even Jesus' clothes, I will be healed." She came up behind Jesus in the crowd and touched his clothes. Immediately, her bleeding stopped and she knew she was healed. At that moment, Jesus felt that power had gone out of him. He turned around. "Who touched my clothes?" he asked. Jesus' disciples pointed out that many people were crowded around him, but Jesus kept looking around. The woman, knowing she was healed, came forward and fell before Jesus. She told him what had happened. Jesus said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. You are healed." While Jesus was speaking, some men came from Jairus' house and told Jairus, "Your daughter is dead. Do not bother Jesus anymore." Jesus heard what the men said, and he told Jairus, "Do not be afraid. Just believe." Jesus and three of his disciples went to Jairus' house. People there were crying and wailing loudly. "Why are you crying?" Jesus asked. "The child is not dead. She is sleeping." The people laughed because they did not believe Jesus, and he told them all to leave. Jesus took Jairus and his wife into the room where the child was. He took the girl by the hand and said, "Little girl, get up." Immediately, the girl got up and began walking around. Jairus and his wife were amazed. Jesus told them to give the girl some food and to not tell anyone what had happened. By healing the woman and raising the little girl from the dead, Jesus showed his power as the Messiah. Jesus died on the cross and rose again to save people from sin and death. When we trust in Jesus, God forgives our sins and changes us to be more like his Son.
Hey kids, we had a great time today teaching you about the prayer of salvation with a little bit of baseball mixed in. If you have not prayed the prayer of salvation, I want to invite you to do that today. Remember, the only way to heaven is through Jesus, and you must say the prayer of salvation to make Jesus the Lord of your life. If you have not done so, let's do so now. Bow your heads and close your eyes. Father God, I thank you for Jesus. I believe in my heart that you sent Jesus to this earth to live, to die, to rise again just for me. I am sorry for all the wrong things I've done, for all the sins I've done. And I ask you right now to wash me clean and make my heart white as snow. Father, I confess Jesus as Lord of my life, and I accept him into my heart as my Lord and Savior. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for washing me clean. Thank you for making me a Christian. I love you and I praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Kids, if you said the prayer of salvation with me just then, you are now a Christian and you are now on God's team. And just like in baseball, they want to hit a home run. That's what you did when you prayed the prayer of salvation. You hit a home run. And just like the crowd at a baseball stadium cheers and roars when someone gets that home run, that's what we all are doing as we welcome you into God's family. Congratulations. Until next time, bye.
Today's secret code is when you're praying the prayer of agreement, find a faith buddy.
Thank you for watching Celebration Online. Kids, I want to encourage you to make sure that you're in church. At every one of our Family Worship Center locations, we have an amazing children's ministry that you can be a part of. If you live here in Florence, come see us. You can meet my husband, Pastor Steve, and see myself over here in Celebration. If you live in Columbia, please connect with Pastor JT and Miss Natalie at their church. And if you live in Georgetown, please go see Pastor Justin and Miss Joanna at their church. And finally, if you live in the Sumter area, we invite you to connect with Family Worship Center Sumter online. You can visit fwcsumter.com to be a part of our online community as we begin building Family Worship Center's newest location. Kids, come see us in Celebration at Family Worship Center. We have a great time every Sunday.